Mr. Quinn, today is effectively a handover from your department to the OPW for the building of this memorial. Can you tell me what work went into choosing the winning design?
The jury was chaired by Sean Benton, the former chairperson of the Office of Public Works, with some representatives from the victims community, if you like. Friend of mine and former president of the Institute of Architects, Sean O'Leary, who was president, I think, at the time that he was invited to participate. And we also had the presence of the International United Nations Commissioner for the Protection of Children, Ms. Marta Dos Santos Pais, if I pronounce her name correctly. She was very impressed, in fact, with the work that was done. I think the design is really very good. It has actually realised, as Brian eloquently said in his own comments to the press conference here, it has realised the full potential of the Garden for Remembrance and has enriched it in a way that I don't think anybody expected.
Absolutely. Mr. Hayes, can you tell me about the design and what the timeline is for building it and what kind of work the OPW has ahead of them?
Well, this is the outcome of a very significant international competition. This is really a piece of art when you look at it, in terms of using the public space that is the existing Garden of Remembrance. It's hoped that a full planning application will go in September of this year. Obviously, we'll have to wait to see the outcome of the decision of Dublin City Council. When that decision's in place, it'll take about 2 years from the end of the planning permission to the building of the memorial. Over €500,000 is going to be spent, provided by Minister Quinn's Department of Education. And we obviously will be working with the team, project management, making sure that we get it delivered as soon as we possibly can. A lot of internal works within the park has to occur. And the outcome, I think, is going to be a really important symbol for the future of this country, recognising the appalling things that happen to young people. Mm-hmm. And also saying, as we approach the centenary of the 1916 Rising in 2016, this will be a major signature memorial for what happened to this country in the last 100 years.
And have you had any feedback from victims groups? What do they think of the design?
Well, they're seeing it now for the first time, and the great thing about the physical model is that people can access it very easily. I presume there will be subsequent feedback of some kind, but so far I think nobody has complained, and Paddy Doyle, who was one of the members of the jury, is very enthusiastic about the project, and I think it's going to enhance the city, and I think it's just a very elegant response to the brief.